ever since Samsung released one UI version, its custom user interface, I think it has gotten better and better with the updates. The most important thing about one user interface is it's very easy to use, and it has, I think, removed a lot of bloatware that was with the previous Samsung's user interface. As you guys know, recently Samsung released one UI 2.0 for its older phones like Samsung Galaxy Note 9 and other phones as well. They are actually running a beta program, and soon in January you'll be getting the stable update for one UI 2.0 with Android 10 version. Now if you are using Samsung Galaxy Note 9 and you want to enter to that program, you can just register it on the Samsung members application and you'll be able to actually get the update and just download it like any other software you download, and automatically it gets updated and you'll be with the one user interface 2.0. Now what's interesting thing about this over the Android 10? Now that's what I'm going to show you in this video. Also how to optimize your mobile phone using one UI 2.0 with Android 10. So let's look at it. Before we begin this video, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Also like and share this video if you like all of these things that I'm going to show you right now. So let's begin this video then. Okay, so the first setting is all about notifications, how you want to change notifications for individual applications. Let's say like if you are using any social media apps, or let's say if you are using shopping apps, if you receive daily annoying notifications, how to avoid that? Just go to notifications inside settings here, and as you can see there are a bunch of different things that you can set and customize according to your liking. Let's say if I go to see all here, you'll have app notifications. So let's say I'm using this Go Ibibo app. Now if I just tap on that, what kind of notification you want to receive from this particular application, you can individually set that, and just according to your preference you can set it so that you don't get any annoying notifications unnecessarily. Even for Twitter, let's say if I just want the notification for emergency alerts or direct messages, I can just keep that and just avoid recommendations from Twitter. I don't want that. Tweets from people you follow, I don't want that. So I can just keep disabling the notifications. This is very nice feature and it's very handy so that you can avoid unnecessary unwanted notifications from the apps. You can also toggle off this suggest action and replace. You can like if you have any notification from WhatsApp or any other applications with messages, you can instantly actually write them then and there. So that's the thing that is with the suggest actions and replace. Similarly, you have LED indicator for notifications, status bar. So if you want this battery percentage to show up, it's in status bar here as you can see, and how many notifications you want to receive, three most recent, number of notifications only, all the notifications you want to receive in the notifications tab. This is how you can customize this one. So it's very nifty feature which you can utilize to fullest with this latest Android version. The next one is privacy. Again, with the Android 10 version, privacy is being very important. You can actually optimize according to your liking. Just go to permission manager here, and here you'll find what app is using what permission. Let's say you don't want the apps that you don't want to use it, the camera, so you can literally toggle that off. Let's say I don't want this Bixby Vision to use the camera of this phone, I can deny here. Similarly, like if I am not using Excel, and why should it actually use the camera, right? So that's how you can disable it. If you don't want that to take the camera, you can disable it. Let's say I'm using this messages, and the messages app does not have to open up the camera without my permission, you can just deny. So deny anyway, this is how you can do it. So this is what you can do with the permission manager. Similarly, all access you have got here, like storage access, what apps has got storage access, you can go through every application and just toggle off if you don't want that app to access your storage. So again, this is really nice and very, very important settings that's on this Android 10 version with Samsung's One UI 2.0. Also, send diagnostic data, receive marketing information, I have just toggled this off. Also, you can control activity from the Google, of course. Again, usage and diagnostics are here, you can toggle that on or off. I have turned it off. This is very important. Permission manager, this is also available on apps settings here. If you go to apps, and if I just tap on three dots here, you will get the permission manager. So again, I would suggest you go to the apps that you don't want to access, give access to storage or other permissions, just disable those things, and it will also save some battery as well. The next setting we are going to look at is with the screenshots as well as screen recording. Again, with the One UI 2.0 updated with the latest one here, you have the screen recording function. Again, kudos to Samsung for providing this one, which was not there earlier. Actually, it should have been their screen recorder. Now that it is there, just tap and hold for more settings. Here you can change the recorder settings, like if you want media sounds as well as mic, if you are recording screen and want actually speak as you record the screen, you can just enable this media sounds and mic. Also set the video quality for screen recording, and there is also this selfie, like if you are recording yourself along with the screen, how large you want the selfie to be shown up. So this is how you can set the screen size for the selfie recording as well. Again, this was not there previously, now it is there. If I just go back here, you have the screenshot toolbar. Again, if I take screenshot, you'll get little toolbar over here. I'll just show you by taking screenshot. So if I take screenshot, this is the little icon you will get here. So if you don't want that icon here, you can just disable that screenshot toolbar. Again, delete shared screenshot. If I just take the screenshot and instantly share it to any of the person, automatically the screenshot gets deleted from my gallery. So if you want to do that, just enable it, otherwise disable. Screenshot format, PNG for high quality screenshots, JPEG for normal quality. Again, screen recorder settings is located here. So this is how the One UI 2.0 has been implemented for better usability. The next one is inside the settings. Again, advanced features, let's move quickly. So here's the advanced features. Here you have got tons of customizability that you can do. The first one we are going to see is regarding the motion and gestures. If I just tap on here, here you'll find finger gesture, like finger sensor. You can use the fingerprint sensor to literally open or close the app, like if you want to scroll up and down. So if I just tap on this one, it will actually show me, guide me, like what you want to do with that. You can swipe up and down to open or close the notification panel. As you can see, I'm using the fingerprint scanner to actually bring down the notification and turn this off. As you can see, with the fingerprint scanner, quickly I can bring down the notification and do the stuff that I want. If you don't want, just disable this one. So again, this is located here inside motions and gestures. The next setting is with the apps. Again, as I said earlier, there is a lot of things that you can customize. So we will go to apps inside settings. Again, if I press on three dots here, default apps. So you can change the default apps for different apps. Like if I'm using video player for, like if I have downloaded any third party video player and I want to make it that default, so you can browse the app and make it default. Let's say I'm using browser app. So by default, I use Chrome browser. So if I just tap on that, that will be the default browser. Any link that is trying to open with the browser will be opened in Chrome. So you can set whichever you want. So this is where you change the default apps. So the next setting is about lock screen. So there have been some customization. If I go to settings here, we will move to lock screen, and there are a lot of things that you can do here as well. The first thing that we'll see is about shortcuts. Let's scroll down, and here you'll find shortcuts. Just tap on this once. And as you can see, there is floating button, the newly introduced floating button. There was button corners. This is what we were used to earlier. Like if I lock the screen and try to unlock the screen, these two are the little shortcut buttons that I can literally open it quickly by just swiping up or down, right? So what they have done is they have introduced this floating button. If I just tap on that one, so you don't get that buttons over here. Instead, you have the three little dots icon. If I just tap and hold, and wherever I push, it gets open. So if I just tap and hold and open this call app, I'll unlock the phone. So you have the phone dialer here. So this is how you can set floating button. Instead of button corners, you can set that. Also, what you want to do with the left shortcut as well as right shortcut, you can assign any apps for that. Again, a little trick that's very useful. The next one is about edge screen. Again, there have been some changes to the edge screen that we usually open here. So this is the edge screen, right? So in order to change that one, all you have to do is go to display inside the settings, and here you'll find edge screen. Here it is, just tap on that one, and there is edge lighting. There's a lot of customizable options here. Let's say lighting style, and as you can see, it just displays as I tap on this one, how you want the notifications to pop up. Again, I'll just love this feature. So you can keep customizing. If I tap on fireworks, there will be fireworks when notifications arrive. There is color, you can literally change the color, you can use multi colors, the color that you want particularly you are interested in. So just tap on done and you have that notification one. And what type of effect you want, eclipse, echo, spotlight, glow, there are tons of customization options like glitter, even you have multicolor glitter as well. So I can change the color, customize color. Also you can change app color, like if I receive any notification from WhatsApp, I'll instantly know that it's from WhatsApp, that's why it shows in green light. Similarly, you can set for different apps as well. So again, very nice and very thoughtful feature from Samsung. So this is why I love using One UI 2.0. You can set the transparency on how you want to receive the pop-up, duration as well. So again, there are tons of different customization options which you can do. So this is regarding edge lighting, right? So always show edge lighting, choose apps for edge lighting, what app you want to receive edge lighting for. You can turn that on for every app so that whenever you receive notification, you'll have that edge glow. Similarly, edge panels, you can customize what panel you want with the edge bar. If I just swipe like this, so you'll get this edge panel, right? So what are the apps that you want to run here? You can literally customize here. You can also download more from Galaxy Store. There is also three dot here. If I just go here and tap on this handle settings, again I can change the handle color. Now that was gray, I can change it to orange. As you can see, it's getting orange over here. So green, purple, or even set customized color just like that. So left hand side or right hand side, wherever you want to set, and how transparent you want that handlebar to be. Also the size of the handlebar, as you can see how it's turning out. So this is with the edge display. Another important setting is inside camera. So let's quickly move on to camera, and the entire interface itself has been quite a bit tweaked to give that little changes with the Android 10.0. So if we go to settings here, what we have one option is hold shutter button too. So what you want to do when you tap and hold that shutter button, so instead of clicking photos, you can take burst shot or you can create GIF, or rather GIF, instantly. So let's say I tap and hold this one and instantly it starts to create GIF file, right? So this is the GIF file, as you can see instantly it has created. Again, that's a very nifty feature and a very handy feature. So it's here, hold shutter button to create GIF and take burst shot. So whatever you want, you can keep that. Just wanted to save that. So the other feature that changed is inside more. So all the options were actually available here. Now that has been moved to more. You can find super slow-mo food and you can actually edit what setting where you want. So there is also Bixby Vision, also AR emoji, just located over here. So other than that, the pretty much settings remains same with regard to camera function. And of course, the picture quality has been slightly improved. Also, there has been some changes to the S Pen as well. So now you can use multiple S Pens. Like if you have more than one S Pen, you can actually use that, while the S Pen default that comes with this one is still tucked in. So advanced features, S Pen, and here you will see allow multiple S Pens. So if I just enable this one, so if you have other Note series, other Note 9, and you want to use that S Pen to do the stuff, you can literally use that one. So guys, in this video, this was it, because there are a lot of things that you can customize or rather tweak to boost the performance of this one. But these are the basic and interesting changes that I wanted to share with you guys. What are the changes that you found out? Let me know in the comment section down below. And there is also this link to Windows feature introduced with the Note 9, which was already available on Note 10 series and the newer versions, of course. With the Note 9, with this update, you have received the link to Windows. I'll be making separate videos on how to link Windows using your PC and this mobile phone. Until then, don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and don't forget to click on that subscribe button for more interesting videos. Alright guys, see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.